Hi guys, today we will see about the heating, cooling and ventilation of electrical machines. In that, today we will learn about the modes of heat transfer. So, heating, cooling and ventilation, it is a very important part in concern with the electrical machines to design it. So, before starting the modes of heat transfer, we will go through some introductory part, that is heating. It is a very important thing in the perspective of electrical machine design. So in the electrical machines, basically it is fundamentally proved that it is working on the basic principles, the electrical energy transferring from one circuit to the another circuit. By transferring it is accomplished with the losses. So that losses are also in the form of heat, and it is dissipated or generated from internal parts like core material as well as windings and insulating materials. So if it is not dissipating properly, then it will be harmful to the internal parts like insulations. So insulation is also one coordinating important part of the electrical machines. So proper cooling system and ventilation system have to provide. It is very important, and it is to be a very proper system to dissipate the heat. Let's start with mode of heat transfer. There are three modes. Modes of heat transfer. There are three modes. First one, conduction. Second, convection, and third, radiation. Let's see one by one. First one, conduction. Conduction is nothing but heat transfer mode which is happening between the two physical bodies. One is a hot body and another one cooled body. If they are coming into the contact with physical contact, then heat will be transferred from higher temperature to lower temperature. Like suppose, for example, consider it is hot body. And another one, cool body. So heated body, from the heated body, hot body to cool body, the temperature will goes on decreasing on hot body, and cooling body will going to increase with the temperature. So heat is transferred from hot body to cool body, that is you can say higher temperature to lower temperature. So amount of heat transfer can be expressed empirically as Q conduction, that is amount of heat transferred in watt, theta 1 minus theta 2 divided by R theta. Theta 1 and theta 2 are nothing but the temperature of two winding surfaces in degree Celsius, and R theta is nothing but the resistance of thermal, that is called as thermal resistivity. So we can write as equation number 1. So equation number 1 can be read for thermal resistivity as theta 1 minus theta 2 divided by Q conduction. Write as equation number 2. So theta, R theta and Q conduction are inversely proportional to each other, and this equation is looking like or analogous to the electrical system. So equation 1 and equation 2, both equations are analogous to the electrical system. So R theta can be written in terms of electrical resistance. Both are analogous to each other. So you can write as R theta is equals to rho TH into T divided by S. R theta is nothing but thermal resistivity. Rho T is nothing but the resistivity of the material, thermal material. T is nothing but the length of the body, and S is nothing but surface of that body. So R is equals to rho into L by A. It is similar to analogous to electrical in electrical quantities. So R theta is equals to rho TH T divided by S, or it can be also read as R theta is equals to T divided by sigma TH into S. Sigma TH is nothing but the conductivity, thermal conductivity. So you can define this thermal resistivity here also. So you can write as Q conduction is equal to equation, and you can write as with the substitution of this equation here. So sigma TH into S theta 1 minus theta 2 divided by this is nothing but the quantity of heat transferred by means of conduction. Let's see second mode of heat transfer, that is convection. The medium for the convection is nothing but the fluid, and fluid is nothing but the liquid, gas or air. If suppose liquid, gas or air particles coming into contact with the heated body, then that particles become lighter and goes up to rise, and heavy particles again come into contact with the cold particles come into contact with the heated body, then again it becomes a lighter and goes rise. Like that it is creating a thermal head and circulating continuously. It is like a boiling water simply. It is called as a natural convection. And there could be an artificial or forced convection, such as blowing air over heated body by a fan. So amount of heat transferred by means of convection can be expressed as Q convection. That is nothing but a heat transferred by means of convection is equal to H into S in the bracket theta 1 minus theta 2 raised to N, where H is nothing but convection coefficient. S is nothing but surface which is being heated, and theta 1 and theta 2 are nothing but the two bonding surfaces temperatures. Like theta 1 is heated body temperature and theta 2 is nothing but coolant, that is fluid temperature. Both are in degree Celsius, and N is nothing but the emissivity coefficient that can be bound or varies between 1 to 1.7. Let's take N is equal to 1, then the above equation can be expressed as Q convection is equal to H into S into theta 1 minus theta 2, and it can be modified as H into S. I am writing here lambda convection. Lambda convection is nothing but a specific heat transfer, and it is theta. This term defines H into S. This term defines theta 1 minus theta 2. Like that, there is nothing but the heat transfer, amount of heat transferred by means of convection. So next one, third, Let's say third mode of heat transfer, that is radiation. Earlier we seen about conduction and convection. Both are having takes place through medium, certain medium. But radiation is a phenomena of propagation of electromagnetic energy. So it is associated with the Boltzmann's law for black bodies, and it can be expressed with the help of the empirical formulas. QRAD, that is radiation, Q radiation, that is amount of heat transferred by means of radiation. Q radiation is equal to 5.7 into 10 raised to minus 8 E into T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4. 5.7 into 10 raised to minus 8, that is nothing but a Boltzmann constant. E is nothing but the emissivity of the body. So emissivity of the body, it is exactly equal to 1 for perfect black body. That is for perfect black body. And it is less than 1 for other bodies. T1 and T2 are nothing but the temperature in degree Kelvin. T1 defines the temperature of surface being heated, and T2 is nothing but the ambient temperature of the surrounding. So it can also be simplified as Q radian is equal to 5.7 into 10 raised to minus 8 E T1 raised to 4 minus T2 raised to 4 can be simplified as T1 minus T2. Here T1 cube plus T1 square T2 plus T1 T2 square plus T2 cube. If you are simplifying this here, you can write like that. T1 is nothing but the what? T1 is nothing but theta 1 plus 273. That is, theta 1 is nothing but a temperature of surface being heated, which is in degree Celsius. By adding 273, it is converting to the Kelvin. Like that, T2 also defined as theta 2 plus 273. So if you are doing this T1 minus T2, then it will become theta 1 minus theta 2. Let's see, that is theta. Let's say that is theta. So it can be written as this equation: Q radian 5.7 into 10 raised to minus 8 E into theta into TR into TR. Now we can define the specific heat transfer for by means of radiation, that is Q radiation is equal to lambda rad theta. So here TR is nothing but T1 cube plus T1 square T2 plus T1 T2 square plus T2 cube. This is the same. So lambda radiation, it is nothing but 5.7 into 10 raised to minus 8 into E into TR. This is nothing but specific heat transfer by means of radiation. This is about the modes of heat transfer. Thank you very much.